Hi, I'm Orit. I'm assistant professor at CU with a joint appointment at Computer Science and the BioFrontiers. My work is focused on the computation that animals do on a regular basis, how they sense their local environment, process this information, and make a decision that promotes their survival. Those sensing cues can be navigational landmarks, they can be concentrations of chemicals, temperature, and more mechanical signals. And I'm interested in how a single animal does this computation alone, and how animals that are in the presence of many other animals, so sort of a collective behavior phenomena, and how this gives rise to swarm intelligence. So I have five hives, so that accounts for something like 50,000 bees. And we are currently maintaining these hives, and then from time to time extract some bees to do experiments with them.
I'm a first year grad student in the interdisciplinary quantitative biology program at the BioFrontiers Institute. And one of my rotations was with Orit, and this is my project. So we're trying an experiment where we see how these worker bees search for the queen. So the queen is in that little wooden cage. Some of them find her, like some of them are surrounding her right now. And then they would fan their wings as they emit this pheromone, and then that would get that pheromone to other worker bees, and then they would form a swarm around her. And I'm planning on working between computer science and biology and ecology, and that's where I want to, or the direction of research that I'm interested in.
With the bee project, we are interested in how bees solve a localization problem, so how they can find the queen in a very unconstructed environment using signals that are pheromones, so they decay very rapidly in time and space. So bees that are very far away from the queen have no chance to find her. So sometimes bees would propagate this signal, kind of like little amplifiers, and we were interested in the spatial pattern of this behavior. So with the swarm mechanical response experiment, what we were interested in is how a honeybee swarm is able to maintain mechanical stability given the fact that it's composed of many, many different individuals. So a bee can say what its neighboring bees are doing, but not what a bee at a completely other side of the swarm is doing. So we were trying to find the local mechanical cues that they might be sensing in order to maintain the mechanical stability of the swarm. And to do that, we created a swarm in the lab and we applied mechanical perturbation to it. So we were shaking the swarm. And by doing so, using different mechanical cues, so different frequencies and different amplitude and different directionality of the signal, we could reverse engineer that they might be sensitive to how bonds to individual nearest neighbors are stretching. And then what seems to be happening is that they go up the strain of deformation. So it's actually harder for an individual bee to maintain these mechanical stresses, but overall for the swarm, that's making things a bit easier.